NADPH has a plethora of functions throughout the body. Recall that hexosemonophosphate shunt consists of oxidative phase and non-oxidative phase. NADPH molecules are produced in oxidative phase, and the major enzyme in the oxidative phase of hexosemonophosphate shunt is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. Glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase catalyzes the first step in hexosemonophosphate shunt, where glucose-6-phosphate is oxidized to 6-phosphogluconate with simultaneous release of NADPH. And subsequently, 6-phosphogluconate is oxidized to ribulose-5-phosphate, also with release of NADPH. So these two steps combine, called oxidative phase of hexosemonophosphate shunt, and oxidative phase results in production of two NADPH molecules. NADPH has three major functions. First of all, NADPH molecules are required for cholesterol synthesis and synthesis of fatty acids. The concept here is that both fatty acids and cholesterol are produced from multiple acetyl-K molecules. As we know, acetyl-K has only two carbons, and cholesterol, for example, has 27 carbons. So to make something big from something small, organism has to condense multiple small molecules into one big molecule. And condensation of multiple acetyl-K molecules into one big cholesterol molecule occurs through multiple reduction reactions, and the enzymes that provide reduction reactions in cholesterol synthesis and in synthesis of fatty acids as an electron donor use NADPH molecules. In these reactions, NADPH donate two electrons and become NADP. Then NADP comes to hexosemonophosphate shunt, where in oxidative phase, NADP are converted to NADPH. And then NADPH can donate another two electrons. So hexosemonophosphate shunt provides this recycling of NADPH electron transporters that makes possible to maintain massive cholesterol and fatty acid synthesis in the tissues, as in liver tissue, for example. So to condense multiple acetyl-K molecules, cell by hexosemonophosphate shunt has to provide numerous amount of NADPH molecules that are used as electron donors in reduction reactions, and this results in production of one big cholesterol or fatty acid molecule. Also, NADPH is required for antioxidant defense, because NADPH are required for recycling of glutathione. To explain this, we have to know that oxidative stress is characterized by excessive production of reactive oxygen species. Initially, superoxide produced, and then part of superoxide molecules are converted into hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is reactive oxygen species. It's a highly dangerous substance that has the potential to cause oxidative damage. So to prevent oxidative damage, hydrogen peroxide level have to be strictly controlled. Basically, hydrogen peroxide level inside the cell is determined by two factors, by the rate of hydrogen peroxide formation and by the rate of hydrogen peroxide detoxification. Detoxification of hydrogen peroxide is provided by glutathione peroxidase. Glutathione peroxidase reduces hydrogen peroxide to water. In this process, two molecules of glutathione gives away two hydrogens. As a result, glutathione disulfate is formed, and very important that in this form, glutathione molecules are inactive. So to become functionally active again, glutathione disulfate must be reduced to two glutathione molecules. And this conversion is provided by glutathione reductase that use NADPH as coenzyme. In this process, NADPH molecules donate two electrons to glutathione disulfate, thereby converted it to two glutathione molecules. And now these two glutathione molecules can be used by glutathione peroxidase for detoxification of hydrogen peroxide to water. So to keep glutathione peroxidase in the activated state, organism has to provide recycling of glutathione, and as we see, recycling of glutathione is provided by NADPH molecules. The major source of NADPH molecules is hexosemonophosphate shunt, and recall that the crucial enzyme in hexosemonophosphate shunt is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. And the third function of NADPH is that NADPH in the neutrophils provides the respiratory burst, which is the mechanism to kill the bacteria. So NADPH also participates in immune defense. To explain this, when neutrophils ingest bacteria, they put them into the phagosome. and then to digest them, they fuse phagosome with lysosome that has reactive oxygen species, as superoxide, hydrogen peroxide, and hypochlorous acid, which are highly reactive substances that can destroy the bacteria. Fusion of phagosome with lysosome results in formation of phagolysosome, in which the reactive oxygen species kills the bacteria. And these reactive oxygen species are formed from oxygen. Initially, oxygen is oxidized by NADPH oxidase that use NADPH as coenzyme to superoxide. Then superoxide by superoxide dismutase is oxidized to hydrogen peroxide that subsequently is oxidized by myeloperoxidase to hypochlorous acid. This process also known as respiratory burst, and exactly by respiratory burst, neutrophils are capable to kill the bacteria. As we see, NADPH is the absolutely essential element of the respiratory burst, and the source of NADPH molecules is the oxidative phase of hexosemonophosphate shunt, and important that the key enzyme of hexosemonophosphate shunt is glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase.